getting up 11.
Yes.
And take him and let your pastor hear it.
Yeah.
Amen. Let him hear the taste.
Amen.
Maybe doing some good.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. What you say?
And all my cords are broken.
And all, listen what he said. Said, now listen, my people are spoiled.
Yeah.
They are spoiled. They know who done spoiled them. Amen. The pastor done spoiled them.
Oh, yeah.
And all the cords are broken.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Can you just imagine if all the pastors was preaching true holiness?
Wow. Amen.
True. And was preaching the same thing, the folks would have nowhere to hide.
Amen.
They would have to get right.
Amen.
Or stay away dirty, huh?
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Praise God. I'm teaching true holiness over here. Amen. The other pastor telling them, amen, it's going to make no difference.
All right.
You can make it to heaven, amen, smoking your cigarettes, amen, right away, and that's all right.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, God wants your heart.
Mm-hmm.
Amen, think about it, you haven't got your heart.
Amen.
When God get a man's heart, he got the whole man.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
If you got your heart, praise God, the old body won't act right.
Amen.
You won't fall in line. Huh?
Amen.
Amen. It's tough, but it's right.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
My children have gone forth of me.
Now listen, you said, my children have gone forth. God's people are his children.
Amen.
Amen. They have been scattered abroad.
Amen.
Uh-huh.
And they are not.
Mm-hmm.
There is none to stretch forth my tent anymore.
And listen, right here, there is none to stretch forth my tent anymore.
And to scatter my curse.
There is none that's really crying out.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Because Israel had got to the place, amen, that the shepherds had backslid.
Yeah. Amen.
That the shepherds wasn't preaching the word of God.
Amen.
It has gotten to the place now where the preacher is not telling them just like it is.
Amen.
Huh? The preacher is not preaching it like the book says.
Amen.
Hmm? Praise the Lord. And the folks are going astray.
Amen.
Yeah.
The folks are going astray. The folks are doing their thing.
Amen.
Amen. And it's all right. Mm-hmm.
But the pastors have become brutish.
The pastors brutish. Have become what? The pastors have become brutish. The pastors have become brutish.
Yeah. Brutish. Brutish. All right.
In other words, amen, you just a slave.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
The pastor done got so brutal.
Wow.
He talked to you just like you just nothing but a piece of dirt.
Uh-huh.
He's the Lord and you the dirt.
Yeah.
But I want you to know, the pastors, that these are not your flock.
Oh, yes.
I want you to know the Apostle Peter said, God's flock.
Amen.
Feed God's people. You quit saying that's your people, that's God's people. And you have an order to feed them.
Amen.
Feed them the word of God.
Amen.
And have spoiled them, and there's no other, there's none to go after them. Mm-hmm.
And has not sought the Lord. Therefore they shall not prosper. And all their flocks shall be scattered.
And all of their flocks shall be scattered. All of their flocks shall be scattered. In other words, there is none to build the walls. For the walls are torn down. That's what happened to Israel, you know, when Nehemiah, praise God, the enemy had destroyed the wall.
Yes.
Had broke the wall down the gates and had destroyed the temple, praise the Lord, and tore up everything.
Yes.
And he saw the condition that it was in.
Yes.
Amen. If you are spiritual, you can see the condition that the church world is in.
Yes.
You can see the situation that is in today.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. And if you got in there, God in you, amen, praise God, you're weak for the slayers of the daughters of God people. And you'll say, come on, let's rebuild the wall. Let's build the wall that was torn down by the enemy. And the devil is glad. He just as happy to be right now. Because the walls are torn down. But I tell you, God want to rebuild those walls. And it's going to take the truth of God's word. It's going to take the people of God to rebuild those walls.
Yeah.
All right, come on.
Matthew 20.
Mm-hmm.
Starting at verse 25.
Now we're dealing here that the Apostle Peter says, neither as being lords over God's heritage.
Amen.
Now he said, neither as being lords your invention over God's peoples. Something that's not even in the scripture, you're going to impose on them things that are not even in the word of God. You're going to give them a cleaner and tell them to go on out there, amen, and fill this cleaner up. But yet you won't send your wife out there. Your wife is too good. I'm going to send a little slave out there. And I'm going to put invention on them. That's my own theory. Boy, they raised me $500. Amen. Had a woman sales, and y'all have pie sales. Amen. Had them chicken dinner sales. All I want you to do is raise the money. And you go out there and raise that money, buy them a new car, and you too dirty to ride it. The pastor, give me a ride. No, my seats are too clean. And you done opened the body car. You see the situation you're in? They said, not as lords over God's peoples. Not as lords over God's peoples. And this is what Jesus said in Matthew 20:25.
But Jesus called him unto him and said, ye know that the princes of the Gentiles exercise dominion over them.
Now, James and John's mother, Zebedee, had came to Jesus and said, now, you know, men are always looking for, you know, praise, looking for positions. And he said, now, when you get in your kingdom, would you permit one of my sons to sit on the right and one on the left? And Jesus said, now, you don't know what you're asking. And then it's not for me, no way to give, you know. You know, we're always looking for some kind of position in the church. I want to be the president. You see, I want to be the chairman. Praise God. The main thing, you just want to be saved. And numbered with the peoples of God. Because if you don't ever hold a position, praise God, you want to be real with God. And so this Jesus answered her question now. Said, now, you know, on the other side, he said, now the heathens, now they love, amen, to issue authority. All right? Come on.
And they that are great exercise authority upon men.
And they exercise authority upon them. Now Jesus breaking it down to them. Now you know the sinner, they love, you know, the authority. They love to issue authority. You see over them. Now, but we are not heathens. In other words, the sinners do that.
But it shall not be so among you.
Now it shall not. He's talking to the church now. He said, it shall not be so among the church, which were his disciples. Or what did he say?
But whosoever will be great among you.
But he said, whosoever shall be great among you.
Let him be your minister.
No, let her.
Him.
Let her be
him.
Your minister.
Him.
Didn't say nothing about no her. It says, let him. Let him be what?
Your minister.
Let him be your minister. In other words, amen, the greatest one that you say, the greatest one among you, let him be your minister. Now, what did it say?
And whosoever will be chief among you.
And whosoever be chief among you.
Let him be your servant.
Let him be what?
Your servant.